Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we are going to do week 6 assignment of NPTEL Ethical Hacking course. So the first question is, 15 parties want to exchange messages securely using a symmetric key encryption algorithm. The number of distinct key values required will be, so the formula for finding out this is n into n minus 1 divided by 2. So n here is 15, 15 into 15 minus 1 is 15 into 14 divided by 2. So the answer is 105. 200 parties want to exchange messages securely using some public key encryption technique like RSA. The number of distinct key value required will be, so the formula of finding out in case of public key encryption is 2 into n, and here is 200. 2 into n means 2 into 200, which is 400. What are the effective key lengths used in data encryption standard and triple data encryption standard symmetric key encryption algorithm in bits? So the answer is 56, and for triple DS symmetric key encryption it's 168. So the first question is, on which difficult mathematical problem does the security of RSA algorithm depends on? So it is based on finding out the it's factorizing the product of two prime numbers, and these two prime numbers which we choose are very large, so it's quite difficult to find out. And this discrete logarithmic problem, this is the basis of, this is used in Diffie-Hellman key exchange. So the answer of first question is prime factorization problem is the mathematical problem which is, you know, depend which is for RSA algorithm. So which of the following types of attacks can the DDoS attack, denial of service attack, can be categorized into? So in a DDoS attack, we basically make the service unavailable, that is we cannot reach the website. So interruption will be the answer for this. Six is, which of the following terms concern verifying the identity of the sender? So authentication is verifying the identity of the sender. So consider a mono alphabetic cipher using the following key values. What will be the encrypted form of the message window? So basically I have to explain this. This is normal ABC and this is our key. So we have to replace this window words with our key. So first is W, which is replaced by S. Then we have I, which is replaced by E. Then we have N, which is replaced by N. Then we have D, which is replaced by D. Then we have O, which is replaced by O. And last is W, so which is sendOS. So the answer is this, sendOS. So the answer will be C part. How many AES rounds are required for 128-bit key size? So in case of 128-bit key size, we have 10 rounds. And in case of 192-bit key size, we have 12. And in case of 256, we have 14. So for encryption using public key cryptography, we use the receiver's public key. And we use receiver's private key for decrypting it. Which of the following techniques are vulnerable to man-in-the-middle attack? So Diffie-Hellman key exchange is the only one which is vulnerable to man-in-the-middle attack. So that completes our week 6 assignment of NPTEL ethical hacking, and thank you for watching.